What's up, everybody? My name is Greg Owens, and I'm from Columbus, Ohio.
My name is Jesse, and we're from Sonic Llama, and thank you for taking some time to sit down with me. I just saw your set. I'm surprised you're dry.
Listen.
There's a very high energy.
That heat, that sun will do that to you a little bit.
Yeah, but you look good.
Appreciate it.
Preserved. This is good.
Thank you.
Okay, so just starting at the very beginning, I saw that you started playing music at a very early age. You played drums in church.
Played drums in church. Started off drums age of 3. I started getting to that about age of 5 or 6. That's when I started playing at church.
Okay,
lessons and all that stuff, so yeah.
I was still playing with Legos, so I'm impressed.
Yeah, I mean,
I was doing that too,
but you know.
Get a side hustle.
I was also making drums out of Legos too.
Nice, so, side hustle thing.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
So like, do you have any favorite memories since you did start so early that kind of careened you into this being something that you would take seriously? Was there anything that kind of clicked at a very early age for you?
I think I just saw like music videos early on I was supposed to.
BET.
Like BET. And I just thought, like, you know what? That's a cool thing to do. You know what I'm saying? People like make music and make videos.
Yeah.
And so I kind of wanted to, you know, do that as well.
Okay.
And tell my story as well.
Okay.
You know, at that time, you know, I was kind of dumb. So I was like talking about guns and stuff like that.
Right, right.
But I realized that, like, later on that once I started to incorporate things about myself and my story, and then people would actually gravitate towards it. So.
Like, you had an honest narrative.
Yeah.
It wasn't like that kind of try, like, you know,
yeah, trying to
find out if you found something for you.
Right.
That's really cool.
Absolutely.
And so there are a lot of really great artists that did start as drummers, like David Grohl from Foo Fighters or Anderson Paak, my recent favorite.
That's who I kind of like, if I was to compare myself with him.
Yeah, he's a good person in England, definitely. And like, what would you say would be the advantage of having a drummer's ear? Do you feel like having that background helps your music and developing
it? For sure. I also produce too, so drums is like my thing. So if a certain sound or a certain offbeat or whatever the case may be sounds good, then like I have that advantage. You know, also have that musician's ear too.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of artists or even producers have that musician's ear.
Right, true.
So I think that's very important.
How do you feel when you hear that beat, that's light, it grabs you? Do you get like...
It's nothing like it.
To be in the studio and just finding something, is it you kind of stumble into it? Like you don't try to force it?
I try not to force it. Sometimes like if I have something in my head, I'll try to lay it out.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But like sometimes it's just a vibe.
Okay, word. I like that. Cool.
Sure.
And speaking of you producing, in 2011, you got a lot of accolade for your release Popular, right? On YouTube, there's a lot of great critiques of it. Like, people was well received. How did it feel producing that and seeing the response, something that you produced at a very young age? Because you were only like 18 at the time, or 19?
I was 18.
Yeah. 18, so 18. How did that feel for you?
It was amazing, you know what I'm saying? When I first made the record, like, I didn't really like it, you know what I'm saying? But like, when I put it on like a mixtape that I had, people said that was their favorite song.
Mm-hmm.
And so like, since that got more response, then it was like, you know what? I might as well do a video to it.
Well, I might as well, if people love it, I might as well give them something,
And so the video actually kind of like went off like organically. Like no press, nothing.
Wow, and they got 20,000 plus views.
Over 20,000.
Yeah, that's insane.
Yeah.
For so young, because you're still trying to figure out what you're trying to do as a young adult, and to have something that was so like legit, like people like this, the evidence is there. I'm sure it was kind of like.
For sure.
Yeah, that's really cool.
And it helped too for the sample as well. So that's Wicked is a popular live Broadway show. So
yeah, oh, too. I love Wicked. I must tear up. Mess up my mascara.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have a little. A musical nerd in you too, a little bit. Okay, I like that. Okay, you gotta be well rounded.
Absolutely.
And so, moving on with a lot more, you produced in 2015, you released the Greg Owens Project. Now, you put your name on it.
Mm-hmm.
So, what made this particular project like important for you that you said, this is Greg Owens, this is my project?
You know, I kind of want to show like my versatility as an artist and also as a producer. At first, it was called Young, Black, and Gifted.
Okay, but that's not bad.
That didn't have really anything to do with the project per se, and like what I had. So it's almost like a collage, almost like a playlist of songs that I made over like 4 years span.
Yeah.
So that's why I call it the Greg Owens Project. So it's more, it's kind of like More Life by Drake.
Okay.
So it's kind of like that.
Yeah. And you have your most recent project is the Eclectic Soul.
Yes, that's coming out this fall. So
eclectic means grabbing from different sources. What would you say have been the predominant genres and experiences that helped create this particular project for you?
Gospel for sure. Gospel for sure. Jazz, funk, even like meditation music.
Okay.
Of course, like rap.
Yeah.
But, house, definitely.
Oh wow.
I love house.
Yeah. I love house too. We'll talk about that later.
Yes.
Okay.
But yeah, I just wanted to, you know, show that that we are all eclectic. You know what I'm saying? We are all not supposed to be the same.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? We're all different.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The soul means like the essence of a person.
Yeah.
So I wanted to.
Okay. Wow.
Show her that. Not just what I'm talking about on the project, but the music kind of like defines that as well.
Okay, cool. And so would you say that this particular project's therapeutic, considering the times now, kind of as a reminder of we're all different, but we all have souls, we're all supposed to collaborate creatively, or just like our day-to-day existence. That's kind of what we're pulling for?
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Definitely. So it's basically like if I was to summarize, basically like a story about, well, it's kind of like having love for yourself and also have love for other people as well.
Okay.
It's basically centered around love, basically.
For you is I was looking up your website, you had a blog on there, and one of your post entries that I felt was the most heartfelt was one where you're kind of young and you're trying to figure out like just school and your life, and you're kind of at crossroads and you're just kind of laying it out there, being very vulnerable with like where you're at. And how would you say now, something that was 2 years ago, you posted this, you've grown as a person, as an artist, just from that experience of kind of like not knowing how to deal with school and just everything any young person is grappling with. It was very relatable.
Yeah, I was like, at that particular time, I had decided to pretty much kind of drop out of college.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because I felt like I was doing it for other people.
Right.
Other people to like look at me and say, oh, you're doing a good job, and everything like that. But really, I wasn't.
The affirmation.
But really, that's not what I wanted to do anyway. So I was kind of at a crossroads. And some people, you know, like people close to me that saw that, most was kind of like a little disappointed.
Yeah.
But you know,
it was risky.
It was risky.
Yeah.
Definitely risky. But I felt like I had to, just not just for me, for anybody that's going.
Yeah, definitely.
So I definitely, after that, I definitely was like, you know, I'm going to try to take control of my life. You know what I'm saying? No matter what kind of obstacles or setbacks I have, you know what I'm saying? I'm just going to keep pushing and trying to do my own thing and trying to. Like I said, take control of my life.
Yeah, and now you're here. Congratulations. You did an amazing job. The second we're coming in, like, okay, what is this? So I wish you luck, and I'm excited to see your release and all of